Welcome back to Entropia Hustle. I'm Grandpa Funk, and today I'm going to be talking about Codex, a basic introduction, and my personal stat priority when selecting the Codex attributes. To begin this video, I have to note that this is a video that reflects my basic thought process, and as far as I can tell, there generally isn't a way to go completely wrong with Codex. However, it will matter more and more the higher level you get, so I do suggest having some sort of focus or goal when selecting your attributes. Due to this, I will mainly touch on what I deem the most important and relevant to me, as everyone will basically have a different starting point with the Codex. So first, for most new players, I'm guessing you have not heard of the Codex. Maybe you're a returning player and you may not have heard of the Codex, but essentially it's like a catalog of all the mobs you have come in contact with and probably attacked or killed or some sort of, and basically it ranks up. So on this one, I'm rank 2. Doesn't mean I've killed 2, it means I've killed like a bunch of these and got to rank 2. But once you've progressed into rank 2, or rank 1 for that matter, you will be able to claim a stat, one of these rewards, as you can see down here. Generally speaking, the reward that will be available for each rank will be variant upon how many you killed, like how much ped you had to cycle to get to rank 5 with boars would somewhat reflect this, because if I went to these minotaur looking things, the reward would be way less, but granted it took less time and energy to get to that. So for instance, if we look at the Drake right here, I'm not even rank 2 with it yet. I've killed, I don't know, maybe 20 of these with our friends. When I get to click a reward just for rank 2, I'll claim complete rank 1, I will choose one of these rewards. And as you can see, it's more than one of the meta attribute challenges. The meta attribute challenges are more important in terms of the attributes that you can get. But generally speaking, with the regular challenges here on each mob, you will get the reward reflected upon by the amount of effort or ped that you generally cycled into them. And of course, it's on an average note. It's going to be pretty much the same for everyone as far as I can tell. So you can't just overspend and then get the reward based on that overspend. To further our understanding of the Codex, we have to move to the meta tab here and click on attribute challenges. Now, this is exactly as it sort of sounds. It's a bit like the regular challenges here, except you get attributes out of it. The difference is in how you rank it up. So for me, I'm rank 36, and this applies to literally every single planet. So the meta challenge in some way is better in that case, because it can carry on no matter where you go. It's not like you leave next island and all of a sudden these aren't available to be ranked up any further. The catch to this is that it's from every single mob here. So every mob that I've come in contact with and killed, it has all come to put the rank up higher, to put the progress closer to 100% and rank me up within the attribute challenges. The other thing to note about this is that it's done with attributes. So you have agility, intelligence, psyche, stamina, strength. And basically how I've understood it is it's always been one ped flat across the board as we go along. I've gone all the way to rank 36 and I don't remember a time where it was less than one ped. Maybe it varies, so from 1 to 10 it's 0.25, and then from 10 to 20 it's 0.5, and then blah blah blah, keeps going up in that sort of a way. However, as far as I can remember, it's been going one ped every single time, and that's a pretty good thing because it gives you an idea of what to expect, and it equalizes the skill, the stats in that way, is the attributes. Now that we have a little bit better understanding of the Codex as a whole, it's time to discuss what the best attribute would be to select as a reward within the meta Codex of rewards. This reward that I'm talking about to be number 1 will be stamina. Stamina influences every action where bodily hardiness, constitution, and physical toughness are involved. That being said, stamina is great for building up your HP. Looking at the wiki right now, this attribute's only use currently is granting bonus health. That's a great thing to have in the game because HP in my book is basically number one. I mean, it literally it keeps you alive. If you had zero HP, then I mean you're not really alive. So you know, taking stamina in this case whenever you really can is the best. You may come in ties with agility as well. I think agility is pretty good too, probably number two on the list. However, stamina to me will always be number one, and I don't honestly see a way of stamina getting pegged down a notch with any others. Even if I was level 100, I would still probably pick stamina every single time, just because that's how great HP is. For those who don't know as well, HP is a bit of a staple or a way to understand or gain a grasp on someone's level or current position in the game, because you know, as I just discussed, it's everything. A lot of people will ask you what your HP is. A lot of people will grasp your stage in the game based on your HP. Another one in that situation is like your combat skill and your evade skill. But yeah, anyways, getting into that later, I suppose. The next attribute on this list will be, of course, agility, coming at number two. Just reading here, agility influences almost every action where coordination, finesse, and grace are involved. This is a fantastic skill. It is definitely second to stamina, according to my opinion and what I've selected, which is, of course, a little bit biased. But that being said, there's great things to be offered from agility. Now, moving on to the wiki. As we can see here, agility is a basic attribute available to all avatars. Agility is a very important attribute because it affects a wide variety of professions. That's a bit unlike stamina, remember, because that all that does is increase your HP. So agility will increase your health. It also increases your avatar's movement speed. Progress in agility can be acquired both by attacking as well as being attacked. Moving a bit down to the bottom here under professions, we can see this skill is involved with the following professions. Straight away, I see Evader. That's a great skill to have. It's a defensive one, of course, but having 8 in that within the skill effect is great. Moving on, we can see some more, you know, combat-esque skills, granted a lot less than the Evader was, but we got laser pistolier, sniper, we have knife fighting, all in hit, by the way. Haven't seen laser damage yet, which is probably to be expected with this one. And then at the back, finally, we have ranged laser damage, but that is only going to be affected by one. Now, this is all of these skills are great if you take into account that, you know, you're going to be trying to level your evader as high as you want. As high as you can, sorry. And that being said, it is somewhat important to have evader. To not kill a certain mob probably comes down to your HP, your evader, and what weapon you're able to use. And, I mean, agility, it's as if you could pick a stamina and agility all day and you could basically kill whatever you want. And for that reason, you know, agility is going to be number two. It also increases your health. It's not nearly as much as stamina as you could imagine, and stamina is so much more that it even outweighs this this attribute in that situation. I mean, the best thing here is the evade that you get essentially, but everything else is sort of like a cherry on top, which really really fleshes out this attribute. Moving on to the last most important attribute here in the Meta Codex under attribute challenges is going to be intelligence. Before I quickly go in depth or go further with intelligence, I'd like to say that strength is also very, very nice. It's just not going to be one of those things that are universally taken. You might take it once every 10 levels or once every 5 staminas, and then 2 agilities you take strength because you can't get intelligence. I don't really know how strength really comes into play in terms of what you're competing against in terms of selection with the reward. But it, you know, it helps with lifting capacity. You know, if you go into here, it'll help with the weights you can carry. I think it also does some other things. However, it's mainly used for like lower level players essentially. It's not it's not that important when you get into a higher level. Back to intelligence, we're just going to read this out real quick. Intelligence influences almost every action where the mind, memory, or reasoning are involved. Now I'm going to bring up the wiki to go further in depth. And looking at the wiki, we can see it says the same thing as the other ones. Intelligence is a basic attribute available to all avatars. Now looking down, it may be a bit more all over the place as opposed to agility, and definitely more all over the place in compared to stamina. But however, looking straight away, animal looter, animal investigator, these are good ones to get. I think archaeologist is nice too. It might be like some sort of a mining one. But generally the consensus here will be a lot of crafting sort of skills. So we move on to number two here. We can see there is even a combat skill here, gunner. I've never done that one before. We got engineer here, like for long blades. We got laser weapons engineer. Those are two skill points, quite good. We got mutant looter as well. We got mining here, metal engineer. Moving down, you got paramedic. This is big, right? Five into paramedic, that's great. You know, if you're not really healing yourself very often, then this is a great start to take, just to ensure that you're not lacking in terms of your healing potential. So moving on, we have more engineering skills. We got resource gatherer. That's a big one. That's generally leveled by chopping down trees. I think it also affects your looter skills. It probably isn't going to tell me here, but yeah. Anyways, I think it does affect your looter skills, but we can't be 100% on that one, and it probably may not be as well, just saying. So robot looter, great stuff. Short blades, great stuff. Spacecraft engineering, don't really know what that's for. I guess engineering spacecrafts obviously is what it says, probably some sort of crafting skill. Before it loads, you can see here sweat gathering. So if you're gonna get a lot of sweat or level that skill, there it is. And at the last page, we have translocating. That's like teleporting. We have treasure hunter. That's always good if you want to go to Treasure Island and, you know, blah, blah, blah. And vehicle structural engineer. I'm pretty sure by leveling this, you can, you know, just repair your ships a lot better, I'm pretty sure is what it is. So to summarize, there's a lot of skills or professions, in this list under the idea of intelligence. So by getting one pet of intelligence, you're going to get pretty much all of these skills in one way or another. It's still very handy to get intelligence. I would get it over pretty much the other ones, which looking here is psyche. I don't deal with mind force, so not a big deal to me. And strength is, as I discussed before, it's great, especially if you're a free-to-play player and you're sweating a lot. It helps with the capacity to carry more. But in general, intelligence is number three. You'd take it only against like psyche or strength if you're in my situation. Now that we've discussed the attributes on the meta codex, we're going to move to the challenges that you will have just with our regular mobs, and you know, see what is available and what I would personally go as number one priority. Now, to first understand here, you will notice that when you go down to the right and click claim reward, that it can vary a lot. You could get less than a ped of a certain skill, or you could get even more than a ped, which is kind of the case with, like, say, where is this there's the Drake. So if I leveled up Drake here, I would get, you know, plenty in terms of whatever I selected there. For the first stat priority, I'm going to suggest, and by the way, this is where things get a little bit more blurry in terms of what you will want, and everyone will have a different sort of priority. So I can only really talk about my own. For me, where I am at the game, I am always looking for evade. And I am always looking for, I think it's here, I'm looking for perception. And it looks pretty bad at the moment. Looks like I can't get it on anywhere. All right, so if I move down to Screecher after that whole ordeal, I can see down here in the third one at the bottom, Perception, just below Melee Combat here. Perception is pretty much my number two. Sometimes I choose it over Evade in this case. Now, moving on to the wiki, you will probably see some more stats to understand about it. And as we've got here, we've got perception, which in general is it's a skill. So perception is the ability to stay observant and aware of one's surroundings. Now, looking down, you can see straight away we've got five in animal investigator. That's huge. That's big. That's what we want. Next, we've got animal looter, which is nine. As I said, your looting skills are important. If you cannot suffice the looting skill for a particular mob, then you will never dream of getting the return you really need, because it all comes back to your animal looter. Having a higher animal looter will give you the returns that you must get from that mob on an average. Going down, I don't see much more useful except for like the hit ones in the combat. Same sort of thing. We have a little bit of spacecraft engineering. A lot in resource gathering. We've got mutant looter and we've got robot looter, just the same as animal looter there. Going to the next one, we have surveyor. That's a good skill to have if you're mining, of course. And that pretty much wraps it up. So as you can see, it's only three pages, and these numbers are a little bit misleading because, when you look at the other ones, like the attributes, it doesn't seem like it adds up as well. But, this is how it sort of is. I think it's done over a percentage here, so 9% of it will go to animal looter and the other ones, which is a huge reason for going perception, if I'm honest. It's why I do it. Yeah, sure, you don't get much in terms of defensive skills, but you make up for it in the looter skills, which puts perception and evade, which I'll be talking about in just a second, at the top. So, looking at evade real quick, this is my personal most favorite skill to take or reward from the Codex. And as you can see here, evade is the ability to reflexively react to danger and to avoid injury when attacked in close combat. Evade is gained by combat with close range foes, while ranged foes develop dodge in its place. So, if you're, versing a robot or something that shoots you, you'll get dodge instead of evade in that situation. So looking right here, we have 25% of this skill that you'll be getting will be going straight into evader. The other 4% will be going into tier upgrading. But this is a big deal when you think about evade skills. It's one of those skills where people will ask you, what is your evade level at? And you want to be able to sort of say as high as you can. If it's 20, 30, that sort of determines what mobs you can hunt. It determines how well you can sweat. All these things come into play when people assess your evade skill. Put it this way, you can't really kill something that has a higher level than your evade. And generally speaking, if you are on par with that, you will have like a very modest time, maybe, depending on your armor. But generally, what I've learned is that if I'm about 10 levels higher from the mob that I'm killing, 10 levels higher being my evade, then I don't have a problem with the mob ever. It's never been a problem. I haven't gotten to higher levels yet. So if you're higher level, then maybe let us know down below. But other than that, evade is pretty much number one, number two being perception. However, I put them in the same category, being just as important. The last two rewards I'm going to talk about is dexterity, and then we have combat reflexes. Now, looking at dexterity, we have dexterity is a measure of the skill and grace of your physical movements, especially those that are hand related. Now, straight up, as you can see, you've got some animal looter, animal tamer, blah blah blah. Move down, you got decoy dispenser at a high percent. I don't know what decoy dispenser is. I haven't played that long, I guess, but there's a high percentage of it. So, I mean, maybe that sways your opinion in some cases with this skill. You got resource gatherer at the bottom here with robot looter. Up the top, you have knife fighting, pistolier skills, sniping skills, mutant looter, even some paramedic. So not a lot of high skills in this case, but it is generally all over the place, which is not too bad, I guess. You got tailor, so making clothes and stuff. I think this is for cosmetics. However, maybe it crosses over into like crafting actual, you know, armor or something. Then you got swordsman hit. So overall, this skill is pretty good. It gives you some basic animal looter skills, as well as like, you know, some other sort of attacking skills, hunting skills, I should say. Overall, not that bad at all, really. Definitely goes second to evade or perception, in my opinion. Now, looking at combat reflexes, there's more of an argument for combat reflexes in the number one spot. It could definitely take your priority here. And as far as I know, it's all about combat. So combat reflexes are the ability to efficiently function during intense combat situation. This skill affects your hit profession on all physical weapon types. That's a big deal, right? And it increases your evader and dodge professions. So basically, it's what it is. You get a lot of combat skills. Defense and offensive skills are all here. You got a high percentage of evader. So, I mean, if you want to level some of your weapons and your evade as well, maybe this is the one. I don't do that generally because when I'm killing things, I'm leveling up that already within the, you know, with my laser rifle or my knives or whatever, right? So I'm already leveling it up, and that's why I sort of go for evade. But right here, you know, this is not a bad second option, right? So, you know, you've got your 10 dodger as well. You got a big 5 in knife fighting. You got pistolier. You got sniping. I mean, yeah, you're going to have all of them here, right? So it is what you can imagine. You got the hit for clubbing and swords as well at a high percentage. So overall, it's a pretty nice skill. Definitely deserves like a number one sort of debate in your mind. Like I would be choosing combat reflexes personally over dexterity. However, I don't think you can go too wrong either way with these two last skills. So I did kind of lie. There is one last skill that I actually personally highly regard. And again, this is all about my opinion. I'm sure there's other skills out there that players who have played for a long time know way more about and would choose any given day easily. But the last skill here I'm going to talk about is anatomy. And anatomy is the knowledge of the body, its composition, and functions. Now, moving down, we can see some great skills here. Straight off the bat, there's Animal Looter. You got 7 for Animal Looter. That's great. We got a high number here for Knife Fighter. A lot of the melee skills here you will see. We also got Pyrokinetic. So if you wanted to get like the Arsonistic Chip 1, this might be a good way to do it. Another one here is Mutant Looter. Moving on to the next page here. We've got range laser damaged, range plasma, swordsman, and tier upgrader. So it's pretty good for, you know, melee in general, right? You're going to get a lot here. Even the laser damage and other combat skills are looking pretty good. The offense skills, sorry. Now, one that I did see on page one here that I missed is paramedic. You get 13 there. This makes anatomy look really good, honestly. This professional reward to choose, I suppose, is honestly a very, very good choice. I don't know where to rank it. For me personally, I'm more focused on evade and stuff like that. But if I wasn't focused on evade, then this would be pretty much it. This would be the choice at that point. Obviously looking past combat reflexes in that scenario. But anyways, there it is. There's anatomy. It's a great one to select as well. Just to understand, you can always go to the wiki up here as well and go under to professions and professions versus skills there. You can go down further just to skills here, and then from there you can pretty much find all of the ones we discussed and all the other ones. So maybe then you'll cut me some slack that I didn't list every single skill, because it's already been a long video, and I think I did a pretty good job trying to give newer players or players who don't know, or trying to re regained some memory. I think I did a pretty good job to, you know, set you back on the path of what would be the easy selections. The easy selections being like, you know, no brainers or most effective, however you want to word it. So that's going to be the end of the video. I know it was a long one. However, I do get questions on Codex. And to put it simply, there is a priority. However, that being said, you know, you may want intelligence more so than stamina. If I mean, I could never imagine it myself, but you may want that. You may be able to justify that reason. Same goes with everything. It could be agility over stamina. Or it could be that you take perception over evade, or combat reflexes over evade, or whatever it is. Everyone will have a reason to select the codex they want, and the challenges, rewards will all reflect basically where you are personally at in the game. For a new player, I think just go stamina on the meta codex every time, and then level evade, perception equally, and blah, 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 as I listed in the video. Shout out to everyone who's come by the stream. I've basically put up a schedule there now, so I'm not going to stream Fridays. That's why you probably didn't see me yesterday. However, every other day I'm going to do a minimum of 4 hours, and some days we'll definitely have more, I would say. I do enjoy doing very long streams, especially on Next Island. I'm going to stay on Next Island for the majority of my time over the months to come. And thanks for watching the video. Subscribe if you haven't already. Sorry to everyone that I probably didn't do the best job for, you know, in terms of the codex and stuff. I'm sorry if I didn't get it all perfect, but you know, I'm learning too, I suppose. Till the next video, thank you all, goodbye.